Well, good morning, everybody. No matter who you are or where you might find yourself on life's journey, whether you're a believer, a doubter, or a seeker, you are welcome in this sacred space. And if you notice, we have a whole bunch of new visitors with us this morning. We are going to be blessed by the Lincolnaires' wonderful music and their talent. And it's welcome. Welcome. You may or may not know, but they use our facility to practice here on Tuesday evenings. Once in a while, I pop in. I haven't been here recently on a Tuesday night, but I'm afraid to disturb them because they are focused when they're practicing. Anyhow, I'm going to let you read through your bulletin announcements. Just letting you know, we're ready to start again. On September 8th, the second Sunday of September, is going to be our kickoff Sunday. So it's an exciting day. Make sure that you make plans to stay here for that. We will be doing Blessing of the Backpacks with the kids. Also, I'm supposed to let you know that we have now received a new order of Vine t-shirts. So if you have not had a Vine t-shirt, you are now able to get one. We should have enough in any size that you need. You're supposed to talk to Anissa Brown about that. She's back here in the very back waving right now. So those who ordered theirs, we've got them out for you. And I believe they're $15 a t-shirt. Maybe you need a second t-shirt. Who knows? Let's see, what else? The Bells are getting ready to start their practices, and today, welcome back choir to your rehearsals. Yay, I could hear you singing even though you were back in the choir room. And any other announcements that we need to be making at this time that maybe have not made it into the bulletin? I will mention the fact that Kaleo is having their annual fundraiser drive of the Kaleo Luau, which is on Labor Day weekend. So that's next weekend, yeah. So if you have not yet purchased your ducks for the duck race down the river, you're encouraged to do so. Just write down Kaleo fundraiser on there, and our administrator will know, and because she's turning in the entries, I'll let you know. I've got money on 25 ducks, so I think you get 5 ducks for 20 bucks. So you know, buy those ducks and help raise funds for the camp. And I'm just going to leave our announcements then at that. Before we enter into our time of worship, I would encourage you to stand up and pass the peace of Christ one to another. All right. I'm going to call back to order into your chairs as you join with me on our call to worship. O Holy One of Hosts, happy is everyone who trusts in you. O Holy One of Hosts, how happy is everyone who trusts in you. O Holy One of Hosts, happy is everyone who trusts in you. In you we go from strength to strength. You hear our prayers, bestow blessings and honor, and withhold no good thing. Praise our God. And our opening hymn is found on page 473, Blessed Assurance. Join with me our invocational prayer. Lovely God, you abide with us. We acknowledge your presence among us with peace, trust, and thanksgiving. It is good to be with you. It is good to be with one another. Fill us with your Spirit and reveal in our worship. May this time give you honor and fortify us as your people, your ambassadors, and your agents of love and hope in the world. Amen. Thank you. You may be seated, and I'd invite the children to come forward. happened to Scout?
And good morning. Everybody say good morning.
Good morning.
Ooh, I love the sound of that. That's great. I love the joy everybody has this morning, and the day is going to get warm. We know that for sure. I love it. I love it. I have some kids. That's okay. Right? Yeah, it's all right. Oh, look at this. There, I've got some children to join me this morning. This is awesome. This is awesome. Good morning, good morning, good morning. How's everybody doing today?
Fine.
Good, good. I love it. I love it. So tell me a little bit about one thing that you think you've done recently that was a little difficult. Little difficult. We're going to talk about things that are a little difficult for us. Okay? Okay. Is this work? Yeah, it is working.
I had to stay out of the path of a semi coming home yesterday.
Ooh, that was difficult. That was difficult. Anybody else? Anybody else have something that's difficult? Okay. All right.
I had to make a very tough decision to change careers.
That is difficult, but you know, you kind of think that maybe those things that help you when things are difficult, you have to still be wise and think about how you can adjust to those new things. Yeah, anybody else? I got one.
I had to fix the doorbell at my front door, and I had to call for help because it took two hands.
So you need to ask for help. That's important. Absolutely. Okay. When I moved from, this is a few years now, but when I moved from an elementary school to a middle school, my principal said, well, you're going to teach science. And I looked at him and I said, but I don't teach science. And he said, well, you will now. And I said, oh, well, then I guess I will. And then I learned to love it, you know, so that's just kind of, you know, change is hard for us, right? Yeah. However, when Jesus spoke to his disciples had to make a difficult decision and say, I'm going to follow you. I'm going to follow your path and listen to you and learn and share with others. That was such a difficult thing to do because some people said, no, I'm not sure I want to do that or I feel comfortable doing that. And we each of us have our own paths. And each of us have our own ways of learning and growing and sharing with others. So it can be difficult in any way that we have. So we always want to do our best to follow Jesus, because if we do, then that path is pretty much set for us, because that kind of a path shows love, generosity, peacefulness. We could name a numerous things, okay? So let's all pray. Everybody repeat with me, please. Dear God,
when paths are difficult,
remind us to follow Jesus.
We love you, God.
All God's children say amen.
And
thank you. And if you want, you can get a Smartie at the back of the church. Because we always hand out.
That's the reason why we do this. Actually, Anissa's referring to the fact that this was a time when Jesus was preaching. This was after the Sermon on the Mount, okay, and when he was given the Beatitudes, and he was explaining it later in the book of John, and a lot of people started leaving because his teaching became too difficult for them. And I love the response, I think you're reading it, where Peter says, where else would we go? Who else would teach us the truth? And I thought, wow, this is great.
Good morning, church family. It is great to see all of your faces this morning. Our scripture reading for today is from Ephesians 6, verses 10 through 20. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the power of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armor of God, so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground. And after you have done everything, to stand. Stand firm, then, with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted in the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And pray in the Spirit on all occasions, with all kinds of prayers and requests, with this in mind. Be alert and always keep on prayer for all the Lord's people. Pray also for me, that whensoever I speak, words may be given me, so that I will fearlessly make known the mystery of the gospel, and for which I am an ambassador in chains. Pray that I may declare it fearlessly as I should. This is the scripture for today. May we hear the word of God in it for us.
Thank you, Sam. For some reason, I thought I had picked the gospel of John 6, which was where Peter was saying, who else will we follow? So I forgot we also were talking about putting on the armor of Christ. Let us take a moment and breathe in and breathe out as we enter into our presence of God. Gracious and holy God, speak to us. So often we pray time is consumed by our words, when what we need most is your gentle nudges and your bold challenge. Let us now take some time to hear you speak to us. Thank you, Lord. Here is now, Holy One, as we lift up to you the concerns that are laying upon our heart this day. Let us continue to hold in prayer Christy Turner and Maddie Elbrick as they are dealing with their cancers. Hear our prayer, O Lord. We ask that you continue to walk with Scott Mitchell and Diana Stover as they also are working on their treatments. Let us pray. Hear our prayer, O Lord. Let us hold Paula and Russ, who are members of Margot's family, as they continue to deal with their health issues. Hear our prayer, O Lord. Let us hold up Paul Savoda as he is getting ready to have some shoulder work done this week. Let us hold him in prayer. Hear our prayer, O Lord. And we want to continue to pray for Russ Workman as he continues on his occupational therapy. Let us hold him in prayer. Hear our prayer, O Lord. What other joys or concerns are we bringing forth today? Margaret. Great, and let us hold in prayer the family and this little guy who decided to come onto the scene. He's so anxious for life that he came so early, has now gained a pound, so he's gaining some weight. Let us hold them in prayer. Thanks be to God. Other joys or concerns? Yeah. So besides the joy of being able to sing music that honors our Savior, you are also invited to join in that choir. So let us pray a thanks for the choir. Thanks be to God. Okay, let us then conclude our time with the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And now it is my honor to present the Lincolnaires to to enlighten our spirits through their voices. And let's go ahead and give them an applause as they start.
I always struggle with these, I'm telling you. To the lady who was up here, tell me your name again, that talked to the children and had a message. She's a teacher. Anita. Okay. Anissa. Got it. Okay. Well, I can kind of relate to her. I remember starting teaching many years ago. And my principal said, Mrs. Hensley, you're going to have about 73 kids in your study hall. And I said, what exactly do I do in a study hall? And he said, you never sit down. And actually, I took that to heart. And that is so true, because if you did sit down, the minute there would be kids in that back row that would start talking and get off task. So I will never forget that. Now, the downside of that is 44 years later, after teaching, I've ruined my feet. And I mean that sincerely. But anyway, that's all water under the bridge. We have our director, Karen Randall, I need to introduce, and Jenny Schnabel is our assistant director. We couldn't do that without those two lovely ladies. We have something kind of different for you. We do sing four-part harmony, and Connie is going to come out and explain some things, because, you know, we just don't magically stand up here and blend our voices. We have to work very, very hard at it. So I think you're going to enjoy this.
our first song mentioned, and as Terry said, we sing harmony in barbershop style. And I'd like to compare that to building a house. The first thing you do when you're going to build a nice, strong house is have a good, strong foundation. And in barbershop harmony, the basses provide that foundation. Now, how's that for a foundation? Yeah. And next on the house, you start to see things that you're not going to see for a long time, like the studs, the 2x4s, the nails, the screws, all the things that are going to go inside the house to hold it together. You don't see them when the house is done, but they're there keeping things together. And that's what the baritones do. It sounds like this. That's our glue. Then next, the house begins to take on a character. The bricks go up, the stones, the wood siding, the things that make the house look like something, and it states the house's personality. And in barbershop harmony, the leads do that. The leads give the song the character. They give us the drive or how we're going to sing it. And they usually have the most words, too. That house has a personality. Now you begin to see, oh, that's what they're trying to put together. Now, it's not quite done because there's trim work, there's accent colors, there's all those little touches that make the house unique, and that's what the tenors do. And we have one tenor today who's going to demonstrate that to you. Oh, maybe two. And then, when the house is complete, you have this beautiful look, and when the song is complete, this is what you get.
Thank you. We love your energy. You keep that up now. As I said, I was a teacher, and I have a couple of little stories about some kids because I just never get tired about talking about some of the experiences that teachers really do have. So the teacher was having a social studies lesson, and she said, "Maria, go to the map and find North America." Maria walks up there, struts up there, and says, "Here it is." The teacher says, "Correct. Now, class, who discovered America?" And the class all said at one time, Maria. I knew that was coming. And then there was a time when, Johnny, how do you spell crocodile? Well, I spell it K-R-O-K-O-D-I-A-L. And actually, phonetically, he was correct. And the teacher said, no, I'm sorry, Johnny, that is wrong. Well, maybe it's wrong, but you ask me how I spell it. I think I would have liked this little guy. All right, we're going to sing probably one of our most favorite songs, God Bless America. I have one more teacher story, and this was a little boy by the name of Jimmy. And the teacher says, Jimmy, the composition you wrote on my dog is exactly the same as your brother's. Did you copy his? No, ma'am, it's just the same dog. I used to love all those fun answers that would come back. Most of them. Well, we want to thank you so much for letting us come and sing on a very warm Sunday afternoon. Please stay cool. And we love coming every year. So please invite us back again. Our last song is One Song at a Time, because that is truly how we roll.
Your voice blending with mine.
That's a hard act to follow, so I'm not going to. I have to tell you how warm you filled my heart, not with just your music, but also with the rendition of God Bless America. Very heart-filling. I'd invite the ushers to come forward. Ephesians 6 encourages us to be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his power. Put on the whole armor of God so that you may be able to stand. Let us stand against the powers of evil that would create barriers to our compassion and generosity to meeting the needs of our community. And let us stand against the powers that would convince us that we lack time to love and to serve God with our talents, skills, and passions endowed to us by our Creator. Let us stand in solidarity and perseverance with a loving God who gives generously, lovingly, and abundantly. I'd invite those who are able to stand to do so as we sing our responded blessing of our offerings, which is found on page 776. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Christ, all creatures here. Closing hymn today is found on page 77. Lord, dismiss us with your blessing.
Please let us hear.
And after our worship, you are encouraged to join us all for fellowship with coffee and water and juice and probably some cookies in Fellowship Hall. Go in peace. Hold on to steadfast hope in a God who does good things, who calls us as ambassadors and witnesses to the kingdom, so sustains and supplies us, whose work is done through our hands, our voices, and our lives, and who remains with us now and forever. Amen.